Having regard to key points in last conversation, first one, there is a strong relation between forestry and agriculture. It is clearly stated at COFO26 that FAO has an important role in finding out how to address the causes of agricultural expansion in deforestation, and agricultural expansion is responsible for nearly 90% of global deforestation, and it's questioned by several producer nations. Also, climate change issues specified on forest-based solution for combating climate change addressed by the committee and underscored through the action plan for the implementation of the FAO-NEF strategy on climate change. Regarding FAO's fire management strategy, integrated fire management, and the global fire management platform being co-developed by FAO and UNEP, discuss and facilitated countries to contribute enhancing cooperation and have chance to share experiences. Further, it is quite important to address roles of sustainable wood and non-wood forest products value chains and sustainable wood energy in helping the world meet the need to achieve resilient and carbon neutral economies. Lastly, it was emphasized the significance of identifying and showcasing successful restoration projects. It is also valuable to have and develop new concepts through the case projects and studies, and also the Thai restoration and national socioeconomic priorities and its promotion of nature-based solution. Next question. As Silvan Mediterranean, our mission is to maintain and develop the Mediterranean forest against many challenges such as climate change and population increase, challenging their persistence and perpetuation, resulting in degradation process of the forest ecosystems and so on. In this respect, I said the key priority is to address these threats, challenges to our forests by sharing information, exchanging experiences and best practices, providing training, as well as incorporating youth in all stage of the process. Over the years, we have achieved many things. The endorsement and submission of the Mediterranean region as a world restoration flagship in the context of the UN Decade on Ecosystem Restoration was an important step. Represented by four countries, Lebanon, Morocco, Tunisia, and Turkey, the flagship highlights the efforts that such countries have achieved and are still undertaking in restoring their degraded forest landscapes in the past year. We have also Agadir commitment for these purposes. Another one, Antalya Declaration, declared the Saint Mediterranean Forest Week call for countries and relevant stakeholders to increase restoration efforts and work with each other to address shared environment and climate changes. And it highlights the importance of the role that younger Mediterranean generation play in achieving this. Following, we care about creating synergy among Silvamet, and recently Saint Mediterranean Forest Week provided an opportunity for member states to address the issue of what they should do moving forward, as well as to reflect on the success of initiatives that have already been undertaken. On the other hand, we give high importance to establishing strong cooperation, collaboration, and coordination with other regional and global network. In this regard, very recently, we organized a joint workshop on forest fires with Forest Europe and DG of Forestry Turkey, as many networks share the similar agendas and overlapping issues. Holding this joint workshop also showed the importance of cooperation and collaboration, as well as the necessity for coordinating among networks. When knowledge, experiences, broad participation, youth involvement, funds, cooperation, coordination with all members, partners, and other networks, all these elements come together, good things can be achieved, and Silvamet with its five thematic working group must continue to move forward by capturing initiatives and applying them with a proactive approach in harmony with member countries, which play an essential role to ensure their successful activities. I thank you.